We have a guest from Ishgard who wishes to speak with you. I believe the two of you have met.
We have. I had hoped to speak with Commander Leveilleur as well, but I cannot afford to wait any longer. The Lord Commander sent me hither to request your aid in a matter of grave import.
You see now why I had Tataru summon you.
Now that we're all assembled, perhaps you would be good enough to elaborate on the nature of the matter which brought you to us.
The Observatorium's astrologians have sounded the alarum. Last night, the Dragonstar burned with an intensity not seen in 15 summers. Not since the Dravanians engaged the Empire in the Battle of Silvertier Skies.
The northern sky doth burn full bright upon the Wormlord's call. The red behemoth beckoneth, and flame consumeth all.
The old Curthan rhyme, aye. The brightening of the dragon's star is said to accompany the roar of a great worm. The astrologians believe that it was Midgard Soma himself who cried out on this occasion.
After an absence of centuries, the King of Kings did return to lead his kind against the might of Garlemald. Only to fall in his duel with the Agrius, proud flagship of the Garlean fleet. Devoid of life, his corpse remaineth entwined about the Magitek monstrosity even unto this day.
Ariange has the right of it. Whatever this alteration in the Dragonstar portends, the Great Worm has shown no sign of life. Tataru, have the Domans reported aught out of the ordinary?
Correct me if I'm wrong, but if Midgard Zorma had roared, wouldn't we have heard it here in Revenant's Toll?
Roar is but a figure of speech. Dravanians can communicate in ways beyond our ken. It is for this very reason that we are forced to look for signs in the heavens. We cannot say with any confidence that a great worm roared at all, much less that it was Midgard Zorma. Only by directly examining the Keeper of the Lake can we be certain. However, it will take too long to gain the Holy See's approval to dispatch the Temple Knights. Therefore, Sir Emric would entrust this task to you. Do you accept? We knew you would not disappoint us. Now, if you would excuse me, I must return and assist the Lord Commander. We have precious little time to prepare.
To prepare for what, pray tell?
When a great worm roars, his brethren cannot choose but answer. We prepare for battle.